ticket brokering is going on right now. Sessions right now in the early sessions going for about $100. The evening sessions with Duke and West Virginia and Arizona involved are going for about $150. But Xavier will kick things off at 12:20 as a number three seed taking on America's darling in Georgia. And those teams that usually make a run in this tournament usually have a dominant point guard. So for Xavier, the key is going to be Drew Lavender. For 5 weeks, he has been dealing with a sprained ankle, but he says now he believes he's 100%. Sean Miller says that will not be a factor in this game. What will be a factor are the seniors, who are now back here for three times in this tournament, Stanley Burrell and Josh Duncan. But they also know about Georgia, now coming in as America's sweetheart, winning four games in 3 days. Xavier knows that momentum can definitely carry you in this one.
It really does, because we've been in that situation where we had to win four games in 4 nights, and we went into that Gonzaga game with a lot of confidence. A lot of confidence. We didn't go in there like, oh man, we're 14 seed or a 3 seed, we have no chance. We went in there like, we just won four games in 4 nights. We're playing great basketball. We're gelled together. And what do we have to lose, man? Let's go in there and play basketball. Man, I know they're thinking the same thing. We got to bring it. You know what I mean? Are they going to send us home?
You got to have a certain focus coming in here. You know, knowing, like I said, it's one game and out. Just be focused, but at the same time, you can't be too tight. You still got to be relaxed and just continue to play like we've been playing and, you know, just be aggressive.
They will have to be aggressive as they get things started off. And then after they are done, all the way across the country, Kentucky will get going out in Anaheim, California, as they take on Marquette. They're about a 6-point underdog in this one. But
everybody, undo your seatbelt. Let's start the celebration.
They're going dancing.
They're dancing like they've never danced before.
We're heading to the big dance.
We're dancing, baby.
We're going to dance with the big guys.
We're going to dance.
The America's Darlings are back in the big dance.
The crowd is charging the court. They're going wild.
Mr. Greatness is still alive.
The party, San Diego.
There's still a lot of fight left in these dogs.
The dogs are dancing.
The Panthers have won. And you should see the celebration.
It is bedlam.
Welcome to the road to the Final Four, powered by the Pontiac GA, as we embark upon our 27th consecutive year of March Madness here on CBS. I'm Greg Gumbel, joined by Clark Kellogg and Sports Illustrated Seth Davis. It's the time of the year where Seth can't sleep and Clark can't eat.
Selection and seeding squelch speculation. It's game time now to make or stake a reputation.
He's so alliterate.
I refuse to follow that. I mean, you're starting the bar up.
That's
really
right,
high.
Way up top. Let's play these games.
And let's raise the roof from there.
All right, guys, let's quickly run down the 8 first-round day games about to come your way here on CBS. Georgia and Xavier will tip off the action at 20 past the hour. Portland State battles number one Kansas, and Temple tangles with Michigan State. Our second wave of action features 4 games tipping around 2:30 Eastern, including Kentucky against Marquette and Kent State against UNLV. Then, some of you will see Cornell challenge number 3 Stanford at roughly 5 Eastern time. Tonight, our doubleheader tips off at 7 Eastern time, and many of you will see Kansas State meet Southern Cal. Now, what makes this game compelling? The matchup of freshman stars, Michael Beasley of the Wildcats, O.J. Mayo of the Trojans.
The new pulse of college sports.
CBS begins its 27th road to the Final Four today in our nation's capital, and leading the way is Georgia and Xavier. The Bulldogs and Musketeers hope the road leads to San Antonio. Georgia is the 14th seed in the West and the SEC tournament champion. Xavier, the 3rd seed and a top power in the Atlantic 10. Lineups, and for the Bulldogs, senior Sundiata Gaines runs the point, averages nearly 15 points a ball game, and Xavier brings a balanced attack to our nation's capital. 4 of the 5 starters average double figures, led by the senior, the guard Drew Lavender. And let's meet the coaches. And for Xavier, Sean Miller in his 4th season with the Musketeers in the 2008 Atlantic 10, coach of the year. 3rd career NCAA tournament appearance. And the counterpart today from Georgia, Dennis Felton in his fifth season. And Bob Wenzel, Dennis Felton feeling the pressure. But that was before the SEC tournament championship run.
And what a championship run it was. Georgia now the lowest seed ever, 14, to play from the Southeastern Conference in the NCAA tournament. He was on the firing line in terms of keeping his job and that great run in Atlanta and his team, the tournament champion.
And today's game is being brought to you in HDTV by HP. First game of what will be an interesting 4 days of college basketball here on CBS. And we're underway in Washington. Xavier controls the tip. And now the question, Bob, for the Georgia Bulldogs fatigue. The 4 games in 4 days, 2 overtime games along the way before the title game against Arkansas.
These guys are 22 years old. They should be able to play 100 games in that amount of time. Are you kidding me? This is the NCAA tournament.
Xavier starts off, and Derrick Brown with the slam with the left hand.
You know, you talk about fatigue if you're Dennis Felton, and you do not want to plant that seed in the minds of your players at all, Craig.
Xavier, a shutdown-style defense, ranked number one in Atlantic 10 play. Their opponent, only 40% from the floor as Jackson rolls one off the rim.
We've got experienced guys on Xavier team, 3 seniors in the starting lineup. All have played 3 times in the NCAA tournament. And of course, no one from Georgia has been in this event.
Suffocating defense forces Xavier out front, 15 on the shot clock. And a good look deep, Josh Duncan for three.
How about that for a start for some experienced guys? A dunk and a three on 2 possessions. Craig, Josh Duncan, 6'9", but a guard skill set.
Gaines skips in, that ball off the rim, a good look and another rebound. Duncan getting it done on both ends of the court. Lavender, contact, no whistle. Back out front to Duncan.
Several years ago, Xavier was a 14 seed, lost to Gonzaga. Last year, a 9 seed, and now a 3. They're moving uptown, huh?
Little by little, 27 wins will do that. And a 14-2 conference record. That ball's cleared away, and down on one knee is C.J. Anderson on the other end of the court as Gaines slices through. Oh, that's beautiful. Left hand. And C.J. Anderson still down. Coming up, Portland State, Kansas. And later on, Temple will take on Tom Izzo and Michigan State. Anderson, the junior from Cincinnati, Ohio.
Well, he is a transfer from Manhattan, and he is a very electric player on the boards. Having him go down early is not a good sign right here. See what quality he has in his step. Seems to be okay, huh? Well, Anderson right here should have made this shot. Missed a chippy, and then when he came down, took an elbow to the face. That'll get your attention.
Well, Bob, what that does as we start our 27th road to the Final Four, that's the early wake-up call here at, 12:25 Eastern time. Hello.
Well, I'm sure Humphrey did not intentionally hit Anderson, but that's going to happen underneath the basket.
So B.J. Raymond, number 11. In for C.J. Anderson.
That hurts them on the boards a little bit, helps them with their perimeter shooting. Raymond, very accurate from outside.
Burrell goes on the low block to Duncan, who's dropped down a three, and that ball out of bounds, last touch by Georgia. 14 on the shot clock, and a 5-2 start for Xavier.
Gaines, Humphrey, and Woodbury, the main scorers for Georgia. They have tried to play very aggressive defense and did so in that run in Atlanta.
Left-handed shot off the mark. Good look by Derrick Brown. Bulldogs trot across midcourt, led by Gaines.
How about Gaines leads the team in points, rebounding, assists, and steals. Also sells hot dogs.
Dave Blitz pushed away from that basket, airballed it. Gaines, by the way, the only player in Georgia history with 1,000 points, 500 rebounds, and 400 assists.
That is doing a yeoman's work.
And the hot dog stand. Whistle baseline. Substitution for Xavier, Jason Love checks in. Duncan goes out. Now, Love came off the bench the first 11 games, found himself as a starter, but today Sean Miller went with the senior Duncan as the starter.
Yeah, Love gives them inside presence physically. The two guys who just came in, Jeremy Price, 270, Love, 255. You think there'll be some banging in the paint area? I think so.
Gaines on the perimeter. Picked up by Burrell. Woodbury, good look off the back of the iron. Rebound Bulldogs and a fresh clock. Lavender on the foul. Took a slice at Billy Humphrey.
Humphrey had 12 against Arkansas in the final of the SEC championship. Of course, that game was played at Georgia Tech, oddly enough, because of the tornadoes at the Georgia Dome.
Inside. Oh, off the glass. Nicely done. Jeremy Price, the freshman from Decatur, Georgia.
How quick he got that. Barely was in his hands, and he got it off.
Well, after a 5-0 start by Xavier, Georgia's answered back with four straight. Penetration. That ball is tipped out. Musketeers grab it. 20 on the shot clock. Oh, there's a steal coming right at you. Good hands, Bob. Gaines grabbed it away from you, though.
He's quicker than I am. Archbishop Malloy in Jamaica, New York. Catholic High School Athletic Association. Of course, great players from that area. And right here, I'm impressed with both teams' D so far in this one. Very, very aggressive.
Now they're pushing both teams out on the perimeter. Raymond wants to dish it deep and hits.
That's his thing, the three-point line. BJ is very, very accurate.
Now, Raymond, though, struggled in that Atlantic 10 tournament, went only one of eight, and drops down to three, the second for the Musketeers here in the early going.
He shoots 41% from three for the year.
Bulldogs turn it over. Their first here in the first half. Lavender, high floater off the rim. Jackson goes up on the top rung of the ladder for the rebound. Gaines with that killer crossover. Hands it back to Humphrey.
A lot of switching going on, Craig. When the guys in the white jerseys, when you switch, it's an effective thing to keep pressure on the ball. Prevents clean shots.
Price rips the net. Second bucket. And what do you know? Georgia hanging tough. Down two. Nearly 5 minutes into the first half.
Price among the SEC freshman leaders in points and rebounds this year.
That ball is loose. Bulldogs are standing flat-footed. The ball, oh, luckily, Georgia grabs the rebound on the defensive end. Gaines weaves his way, high floater. Jackson put back, overshoots the hoop, and the Musketeers run out of the pack. Lavender so quick. Bob got caught underneath. Really overran the basket.
Humphrey got a piece of it also. He's given away about 7 inches on that.
Woodbury, good look. Deep three, got it. Oh, Georgia. How about this start? Bulldogs down five, now lead by one.
Woodbury 16 against Arkansas, 17 against Kentucky. Did we mention they played two games in one day and won both?
One of the great stories of college basketball. In fact, their first SEC title since 1983. Dumped down low. Oh! The flush! And the bucket. Price is having himself a big, big first half. 11-8, Georgia, the 14th seed against number three. And Price is a perfect 3-for-3 to start.
And his power very, very evident in this one already. 270 pounds, 6'10", and good hands.
Burrell, Lavender, out on the wing, drives, there's that floater, and again, can't find the bottom of the basket, backside rebound, and here comes Georgia. Albert Jackson to Gaines, long three. Xavier rebounds, and they're going to get that ball quickly to Lavender. And quickly, the finger roll by Derrick Brown, second bucket here in the half.
Brown is the most athletic of all of the Musketeers.
human highlight reel. Can really, really fly. Filled the lane very nicely there. A 59% shooter from the floor. A penetrator. How about the Georgia Bulldogs leading Xavier here early?
Late to CBS.
Now, Georgia with the one-point lead on Xavier, the 14th seed against number three. And how about the 2008 SEC tournament? Will we be remembered for the tornado that struck downtown Atlanta? And the Georgia Bulldogs, they played four games, 4 days, and won two overtime thrillers en route to their first SEC title since 1983. And there the Nets go down. Four tourney games, 4 days, Ole Miss in overtime, Kentucky in overtime, Mississippi State fell, and then Arkansas goes down in the title game, and Georgia, the lowest seed in the SEC.
Ever in the history.
Ever.
Ever in the history of that
tournament
finally.
Champion.
Pretty remarkable story.
Well, what's remarkable, they won four games, and that's the total conference wins the entire conference season. 4-12 during the regular season with Georgia, and then they rip off four straight in Atlanta.
They were last in the SEC East in the regular season.
The double team down low, a whistle. And Bliss came over for some help defense.
All right here. Double and triple teaming inside is the order of the day. Georgia, very, very big inside. Jackson has got six rebounds already in the game. He's at 250, Bliss 255, Price 270. So plenty of beef in there for the Dogs.
Jason Love, 61% shooter from the free throw line. Well, coming up on AT&T at the half, Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg, and Seth Davis will take you out for a live look at all the action going on in the NCAA tournament, and they'll get you caught up in all the latest tournament news, plus an AT&T Naismith update. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half. One for one, Love. Back comes Georgia, good look, and Duncan rips down another rebound.
So far, Georgia getting back quickly. Very few breakaway situations for Xavier at all. Lavender not in the game. Burrell will do the duties at the point right now for the Musketeers.
Duncan lost that ball out of bounds, and Georgia will have possession with 12:09 to play. First half.
Frequent substitutions on the part of Sean Miller early in this game, Craig. He doesn't want his guys to get fatigued early. A lot of times the emotion of the first game of the NCAA tournament can do that to players. So guys have been in and out. Three cleanly played games so far. Ball handling has been good.
Bob, one reason to explain why six players average double figures. They're the only team in Division I to do so.
That's pretty remarkable. And you talk about sacrifice. Guys getting the ball to their teammates. Number one priority for the Musketeers.
Greg Gumbel, Seth Davis, Clark Kellogg in New York. We'll get you right back after we check out what's happening first in Midwest region play in Omaha. Portland State, welcome to the NCAA tournament. This is what the big time is like.
Well, too much size, too much balance for Kansas. Portland State, their only hope was to knock down shots early. That hasn't happened. They make nine threes a game, and they're 1-for-9 from the floor. And Kansas in the midst of a 9-zip run right now.
Remember, this group of Kansas players lost in the first round 2 years ago. They understand the dangers of being complacent in the tournament. Portland State so far has committed 5 turnovers, Kansas all over.
And Portland State, with its first ever NCAA tournament appearance, you can give them a little slack for being nervous about the first time ever.
Without question, and facing a team as imposing as Kansas is. There you see Darrell Arthur grabbing a missed free throw and going right back to the foul line. So again, an indication of the size advantage Kansas has right there.
13-3 Jayhawks. Meanwhile, in Denver, Temple and Michigan State, a one-point game at this stage.
Well, Drew Neitzel missed his first 3 three-point attempts, make that his first 4 three-point attempts, so he is scoreless in the game. But Michigan State's playing pretty good defense at the other end, so they've got a kind of a low-scoring type of mode. I think they'd like to open it up a little bit, but so far, the Spartans look pretty good on defense.
Yeah, doing a solid job defensively. I think it's going to be important for Drew Namek, Boren Sutton for Michigan State, to be a real presence inside, to try to wear down the outstanding young freshman for Temple, Lavoy Allen, and then also almost for Temple as a 7-footer. But inside, being able to compete inside will be a key, I think, for Michigan State.
All right, guys, 14 minutes to play in the first half there. We'll keep you posted on all of these games. Right now, back to Washington, D.C., Georgia and Xavier, Craig Bowler-Jack and Bob Wenzel.
Block shots, Bliss. You are on the floor, player.
Bliss picks up his first. One of the co-captains, along with Gaines for Georgia,
had back trouble for two seasons. Now in his senior year, really, really happy about being here. Good leader on this team.
First free throw attempts, and Duncan's off the mark. Duncan hit a three early for Xavier. Raymond's dropped down a long shot, and we've had a couple hit by Georgia. Gaines a moment ago, and Woodbury hit one in the first couple of minutes.
Those are numbers that Duncan provides for his team. A great free throw shooter. Also shoots 43% from downtown for a 6'9 player. That's good. Anytime you get up in the high 30s from three-point range, you're doing positive things for your team.
Well, Duncan makes one of two. And trims Georgia's lead down to two. Swansea out front against Lavender.
Swansea, 39-inch vertical jump, number five.
Takes a long shot off the back of the rim. There's Duncan. Boy, he has really done a great job with defensive rebounds. That's four.
6'9 and 235. Very, very experienced senior.
Raymond, good look. Georgia, it's one and out for Xavier.
They're rebounding well at the defensive end, as you mentioned, but not getting after it on the offensive boards. That's because Georgia is physical, and they are a good defensive rebounding team.
Oh, Woodbury. Second three ball, and right now Georgia with confidence up by five. And nearly halfway through the first quarter here in Washington.
Dennis Felton on the sideline, extremely animated.
Lavender, you can do it, I can do better. Lavender, the senior, Columbus, Ohio. This guy is fearless.
He is a transfer, played 2 years at Oklahoma and played in the NCAA tournament his sophomore year there, Craig. And, of course, has played here as well in his third game last year.
Driving, hanging. That's a great move. Woodbury outside now takes it in. 8 points, Woodbury. 19-15, Georgia.
Last year, Xavier beat BYU in the first round, then had a heartbreaking loss to Ohio State in overtime. And these guys played in those games, so they know what this is all about.
C.J. Anderson will return for Xavier.
How about Woodbury getting off to a good start, huh? 8 points already in this one. He only averages 10 on the season.
.24 on the shot, 9:17 to play, first half. Drew Lavender. Did I mention he's only 5'7"?
He looks pretty small out there, doesn't he?
Don't ask him about the size. Doesn't matter. Up and in.
Oh. How about that? A lob to your 5'7 guy. That'll fool most. That's not on the scouting report, I guarantee you.
19-17, Georgia. Lavender now with 5 points to lead the Musketeers. 8 for Woodbury to lead the Bulldogs. Under 9 to play, first half. Gaines out front. On the wing, Woodbury. Oh, there's a tough double team. They love to come out and meet you.
The cardinal sin. Double team, but don't foul. And right there, they had an advantage. Didn't do much with it. Right here, the terrific pass by the two guard to the point guard. Wide open on the weak side. Nice clear out. Usually, if that's to Burrell, it would be a dunk, but to Lavender, I would say he's a little height challenged.
But you know what? There's that statement about totally being fearless. He'll take it up against anyone.
Roll reversal on that play.
Humphrey, dribble drive, goes baseline, closed down, took the step, paused, and drops in two. Billy Humphrey's first bucket, averages over 12 points a ball game. You get the feeling maybe these teams beginning to open things up a little bit.
Yeah, starting to flow a little bit.
Xavier spinning, and that shot by Anderson is clogged up in the paint, and the whistle.
Anderson's an unusual player. He is sort of a three-man in a four-man's body, or the reverse. He's a good forward, and he's very, very aggressive taking the ball to the basket.
Gaines picks up the foul. No shot. And Xavier will inbound. Out front to Burrell. Three on the way. Off the mark. Price reaches up and clears it to Gaines.
When Price goes up, the lane gets cleared. He clears bodies out of the way.
Oh, Gaines backside, hangs on a pivot, the feed, and Price with a two-hand slam. Price with 8 points in the first half. And stays perfect, 4 for 4 from the floor.
How about that for a pickup off the bench? That's what he averages on the year. Big time contribution from Price in this one.
Well, you see no freshman jitters in Jeremy Price out of Decatur, Georgia. 23-17, Bulldogs in the paint. Burrell tried to bank it off the glass, and Gaines now at midcourt. Clears again, Woodbury, the hot hand. Back to Gaines, that ball is picked. Loose. Still on the floor, everybody hustling. Georgia rolled out of bounds, and it will be Xavier basketball when we come back. Two hands up and in by Jeremy Price, and the Bulldogs of Georgia leading Xavier 23-17.
Hey.
6-point lead for Georgia here in the first half in Washington, D.C. 7-10 to play first half. As we start off the road to the Final Four here on CBS, Craig Bullerjack and Bob Wenzel. You know, you look at stats, 48% shooting now by Georgia. How about the turnover? Xavier has turned the ball over three times, and Georgia was 7 points off those turnovers.
Yeah, and they've only got one turnover right here. So it's a pretty cleanly played game. Not a lot of turnovers by either team with this much time left in the first half. Also, rebounding is a big story. Right now, Georgia has 3 offensive, Xavier only 2. Both of these teams doing a good job handling the ball and doing a good job protecting their own backboard.
Now, we talked about fatigue at the start of this game. Remember, Georgia playing 4 games in 4 days in Atlanta. Won the SEC tournament title. That's why they're here and ranked as the 14th seed. I see no fatigue in this first half.
None whatsoever. Adrenaline is high in this game, of course. It's the NCAA tournament. Georgia hasn't been here in a long, long time.
Lavender floater off the mark. Rebound put back. Oh, it rims out. That ball is loose. Everybody up for it. And Georgia comes out of the pack. Boy, the Bulldogs are jumping. Jeremy Price, another rebound.
Their confidence level is through the roof after winning that championship in Atlanta.
Swansea hangs on a pivot, gives it away. Woodbury between his legs, out on the perimeter. 19 on the shot clock.
They look nothing like the team that was 4-12 in the Southeastern Conference.
That ball was tossed away. Turnover, Georgia, with 6:22 to play in the half.
How about some stars on this team during the SEC tournament? Swansea hit a 3 to beat Kentucky in overtime. Gaines was the most outstanding player in the tournament. Swansea, that was his only shot at the game, and he beats Kentucky. And Bliss banked one in with 0.4 to beat Ole Miss.
How about the number Gaines put up in that tournament? 17 points, 4.5 rebounds, and 3.5 assists. Preach ball comes off the rim, and a loose ball foul.
You know, people talk about Xavier, and, you know, they were 14, they were 9, and this year they're a 3 seed. Stanley Burrell and his teammates got a 3 seed because they played such a tough non-conference schedule. Beat Indiana, beat Kent State, beat Creighton, played Arizona State and Tennessee, beat Kansas State. The only game this year that Michael Beasley did not go in double figures. So Sean Miller challenged his team outside of the Atlantic 10 as well.
Under 6 minutes to play. Georgia with the lead of 23-17.
Watch Stanley Burrell, number 34, on Gaines right here. They switch. See how that happens? That way you maintain your pressure.
Butler goes on the low block to Jackson. 8 on the shot clock. Woodbury has to back it out. Tenacious defense by Xavier. Jackson, left-handed hook shot, falls off the rim. And the Musketeers rebound.
That was
guess who? Josh Duncan.
That was a great defensive possession by Xavier.
Burrell bumped. And I believe that's going to go against Corey Butler. Butler's first. Well, we talked about Xavier increasing their seed each year in the tournament. And, of course, the reason they did that, they won more games, Craig. And then they also played tougher non-conference competition. And that's why they got into that position. Lavender inbound, Burrell. Down low, Duncan, one bounce, double teams, and muscles up two.
Boy, he's playing good, huh?
Duncan keeping Xavier close with 6 points to lead the Musketeers. It's 23-19, Georgia. Humphrey gives it up, down low. Jackson clears. 20 on the shot clock. Butler drives it up. Well, that ball kicked off the iron. And Xavier now, you feel the emotion beginning to switch back.
Good intensity in the game, don't you think?
Oh, gotta love it.
Up close, these guys are moving quickly.
Brown over the top. Duncan puts it on the floor. Baseline clears it. Back out. Pump shot off the glass. Double pump inside. Count it. Oh, they're working hard. Derrick Brown's third bucket. 6 points for the sophomore from Dayton.
That's what Xavier needs.
Duncan now with 6 rebounds. Inside, that looks like an easy deuce, but Duncan comes by with some defensive help.
The long arms of Josh. He wants to shoot it here. What an unselfish play. He was ready to rock and roll there.
Burrell squares the shoulders, rims out. Woodbury with the backside rebound. 23-21 Bulldogs, 4 minutes to play. First half. Well, how about the breakdown, Woodbury? Three bounces and down.
That is a very, very difficult shot.
Woodbury hits double figures here in the first half. Timeout Xavier. Georgia by 4. Well, Bob, you look at the game summary. The numbers are even. However, Georgia shooting the ball just a little better than the Musketeers. 3-point shooting, both 3 of 8 for Xavier, 3 of 6 for the Bulldogs. How about the rebounding? Both teams really going after those loose basketballs.
And Terrence Woodbury has been the star offensively. He's got 10 points in this game. He has only missed one shot. He's doing it from the outside, and that is where he is really, really dangerous. He's got 4 rebounds as well, and it's a good thing because Gaines only has 5 points in this game. Woodbury has really taken up the slack.
Now, Woodbury already at his season average in the first half, yet still over 3.5 minutes to play in the first half. You're right, Gaines with 5 averages, nearly 15.
Yeah, so that's a great combination, those two guys. Woodbury's numbers have improved the last third of the season, starting to gain confidence, and of course, feeling as confident as he can be right now.
Jackson, one bounce.
Look at the length of the guys in the red jerseys. Look at the pressure on the basketball.
Brown pops free, long range shot, hits it. Derrick Brown with 9 to lead Xavier, and the lefty from long range. Dayton, Ohio is home, only a sophomore.
He is the most athletic of all of the guys in the white jerseys. Defenses look similar, don't they?
Oh, they do.
Guys down in their stance, wide stance, hands tracing the basketball, right? Arms out. And some power in the paint. Keep an eye on Love and Bliss inside. Look at this.
Big fella goes in, left-hander off the glass. Oh, what a kiss that was. Bliss first bucket. All 5 starters are now scored for Georgia. 3-point ball game. 2:42 clock running, first half. Burrell behind the screen.
He's not been good from the outside in this game so far.
Love rolls it in and rolls it off. Bliss picks up his 2nd foul, and the deep shot drops for Derrick Brown. Good ball game here in Washington. Georgia by 3. We'll be right back.
all-new Sequoia. It's anything but ordinary.
Hey, speaker. He's an extremely...
He's not a celebrity, but he's famous. He's not a politician, but people know what he stands for. He's not a preacher, but he does have a devoted following. Congrats, Jared, on an amazing feat, losing 245 pounds and keeping it off for 10 years. Happy we could help with our mouth-watering, low-fat subs. Subway, eat fresh.
At TIAA CREF, we provide financial solutions for those who serve the greater good. We offer personalized objective advice, a commitment to consistent growth, low fees.
Hi.
Well, Georgia on an 8-0 run and made their last five field goals, 33-24 the score, and CBSSports.com covers every minute of the madness. Get expert analysis, watch highlights and buzzer beaters, plus live scoring and stats for every game, all at CBSSports.com.
1-3-1 zone, check this out. It's been effective. That is the best basket. And how about that after a timeout? Sean Miller, very intelligent play. Tried to describe to his guys where the seam was. They had struggled for three possessions. That is good coaching, my friend.
8 points now for Duncan, a senior from Cincinnati. 5 seconds separating shot and game clock here to end the first half. Humphrey turns on a pivot and hits. Boy, Georgia is as hot as their uniform. Red hot.
6 points for Humphrey. I'll tell you what, he did a terrific job right there. You don't want to run the shot clock down when there's that large a differential. Just get a good shot.
Raymond, unaware, couldn't get it away as the horn sounds. Georgia ends the half with six straight buckets. It's 35-26 Georgia over Xavier. Let's go down to Great Gumbel in New York with AT&T at the half.
Gus, thank you. The amazing Georgia Bulldogs continue to roll. Meanwhile, in Omaha,
or visit drivechevy.com today. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the men's basketball championship is sponsored by Chevy. Jordan, Charles Schwab, and by Holiday Inn Express.
Back in our nation's capital, Washington, D.C., moments away from the start of the second half. Craig Buller, Jack, along with Bob Wenzel. 35-26 Georgia, the 14th seed against the number 3 Xavier Musketeers. I see confidence for the Bulldogs, which equals intensity in the first 20 minutes.
And that's why Xavier only shot 34%, because that intensity translated to very, very good defense. And they were tough inside. They took the ball to the basket. Price, who is 6'10 and 270, 4-for-4 on like shots like that, close to the basket. Gaines driving hard, using the left. And of course, Albert Jackson, the easy finish on the break. They were tough inside. Terrence Woodsbury, of course, had 10. He was the leading scorer on this team. Brown and Duncan carrying the load for the Xavier Musketeers.
Well, the in-game box score powered by CBS College Sports Network, the 24-hour college sports channel from CBS Sports.
This is a very surprising game to me.
I mean,
Georgia's a great story, of course. The Cinderella SEC champions, 3 days in Atlanta, were 4 days in Atlanta were great, but they have come in here and really shown heart, huh?
Well, we start the second half much like we finished it. Intensity, confidence by Georgia Bliss. Tips in the miss, second bucket for the big fella, a 6'10 senior.
How about tipping it in with his offhand as well?
And now a jump ball. How about 53% shooting by Georgia in the first half?
Got quality shots, a lot of close-in ones, and they shot four threes as well. Bliss only played 6 minutes in the first half because he had two fouls. He's already got his presence felt right away here.
Lamader on the inbound finds the hot shooter in the first half, Josh Duncan, out of bounds. It'll be Georgia basketball.
Craig, if you're interested in trends, Georgia is 14-4 when they're leading at the half. Xavier trailed at the half only five times the whole year. They lost four of them.
Down 11, down 9 at the break. Georgia comes across the timeline. Sundiata Gaines. Left to right hand dribble. Patience, also a big key for the Bulldogs. Humphreys, that ball is slapped away. The quick hands of Lavender. Anderson gets out and runs for the Musketeers. Leaves it out. Little fella, high floater. Oh, it came out. It went back in. Thanks to Derrick Brown. That's 11 for Brown. And double figures. And again, high percentage shots is his M.O. 59% from the floor. And a travel. One of few miscues by the Bulldogs here in this ballgame.
Only four turnovers for them at all. That's good handling.
NCAA March Madness on Demand is streaming every game from the NCAA Championship online for free. You can watch it any game, anytime at the new NCAA.com. Boy, it's this time of year, Bob. Everybody becomes a college basketball fan.
The office workers, they still have that boss button where you turn it off if the boss comes on.
I'm sure bosses are looking over the shoulder now as Duncan drives baseline. Oh, coming back.
The bosses are watching too. Are you
kidding
me?
Yes, they are. They're watching Albert Jackson come flying in defensively, but picks up the foul, his second.
A lot of high-flying stuff going on in this game with Jackson. He's really improved in the last third of the season. Duncan, a mainstay senior. Big numbers.
Duncan. Now one of three, and near the end of today's game, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team, and to honor their determination and outstanding play, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each University General Scholarship Fund. Chevy, an American Revolution.
86% free throw shooter, misses both at the line. Highly unusual.
Now one of four in this game. Out front, Burrell putting the pressure defensively on Gaines, takes a spill and a whistle.
Well, they are very concerned about Gaines, and they are switching everything on him. Everybody's trying to get involved. Little trip right there. Burrell is the player of the year defensively in the Atlantic 10. That's why he's been assigned to that man.
Bob, great feet. If you watch how fast he shuffles those feet, he can move from one side to the other in no time.
Here's a guy who can move.
Breakaway. Lavender.
5'7", a burst of speed.
Well, Lavender injured that left ankle, remember, back in mid-February against Charlotte. And we talked to Sean Miller in length yesterday. Really feels like he is back all the way.
Yeah, and his numbers went way down in the next seven games after that ankle injury.
Turnover, Georgia. Oh, nearly. Bulldogs get it right back. They feed it down low and a whistle. How about Albert Jackson's play on the baseline, on both ends, offensively and defensively?
I'll tell you, he's a guy who didn't start playing basketball until he was much later in his years. From Kentucky, new coach Felton when he was the coach of Western Kentucky. Didn't play before the eighth grade.
That's amazing.
Yeah, that is pretty amazing. And of course, he has gone on to become an excellent player for this team in the latter part of this season. Only a sophomore. Coach Felton. He feels more comfortable on that seat right now. It was hot last week, but...
He could barely sit in Atlanta. I mean, he was jumping. Well, Damon Jackson Evans drops down too.
Sorry, Damon Evans, the athletic director, was quoted as saying, of course he'll be back, referring to Coach Felton, and that's good to see.
Lavender. Oh, there's a pocket that's picked. Gaines. Up he goes!
How do you steal the ball from a 5'7" player? Gaines not even celebrating like he does it every day.
41-30, Georgia, 14th seed of the West against number 3.
Take a look at this steal. Gaines gets way low and steals it from the smallest player maybe in a tournament. And it's the easy finish for Mr. Gaines. Boy, I'll tell you what. Stoic demeanor on the floor. A lot to admire in this young man.
Bob, Lavender is the player everyone knows around the Atlantic 10 as the guy that usually goes under double teams. But this time, he couldn't handle the man-to-man defense. And a timeout. 41-30, Bulldogs.
You're watching the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship on CBS.
Well, welcome back, Washington, D.C., and maybe an upset in the making. Stay tuned, Georgia and Xavier. They say it's impossible for an underdog to go the distance. Then again, they said it's impossible to get real Coke taste and zero calories. Log on to MyCokeRewards.com and get lots of great NCAA gear.
Well, lots of smiles on the faces of the dogs as they come out here. Nice, comfortable lead. Sundiata Gaines is playing a terrific game in all phases. And their defense has been superb, limiting to Xavier to about 33%.
Bob, can I say it? Who let the dogs out?
They are out now, believe me.
Oh, they're all the way from Atlanta here now to the nation's capital. Four straight wins in the SEC tournament. Found their way into the West region as the 14th seed and now lead Xavier by 11.
Matchup zone for the first possession of the game. They used a 1-3-1 in the first half.
Lavender.
Very confusing.
So quick, pops that jumper, down she goes. Lavender 9 in the ball game. A 5-point first half.
It is not often that a 14 seed beats a 3 seed. Last team who did it, Northwestern State in 2006. Beat Iowa.
Well, can it happen again? Stay tuned. Bliss hands it off. Woodbury, right to left hand, pull up jumper from 12. That's a beauty. And he knows it.
Oh, he ran right by us with his mouth open and his smile. That is a tough shot when you pull up going to the left. You've got to be on balance, and he was.
How about the shooting? 5 of 7 from the floor. Lavender out front, swings it down low. Duncan holds, drives on Bliss. And a whistle on a reach in. And that will be 3 on Bliss and a timeout. Georgia on top of Xavier by 11. We'll be back on CBS. The first of 4 games here in the West region in Washington, D.C. Rick Overjack, Bob Wenzel. Bob, what a start. 14th seed Georgia, 11-point lead over Xavier, the 3rd seed in the West. What a start.
I'll tell you what an improbable season it's been for Georgia. The coach is rumored to be fired. They go 4-12, SEC, last place, and then they win the tournament.
Well, Duncan's at the line to shoot free throws. Down 11, and it trims up to 10. Duncan with 9 points, 8 in the first half. Moeller High School, Cincinnati, Ohio.
Only 2 of 5 from the free throw line today. Normally very reliable at 86%.
And drops down a pair. And Duncan's in double figures to join Derrick Brown as the only Musketeers. It's 43-34. Duncan will take a seat. .15-37 on the second half clock here in Washington, D.C. An upset in the making? Maybe. Georgia continues to play well as Butler tried to go around Raymond and turned it over. That's a rare miscue by the Bulldogs here in this ballgame.
Yeah, they've really handled the ball very, very well throughout. Dennis Felton's team on a mission right now, playing as well as they can play against the 3 seed. Keep in mind now, Xavier's players have been in the NCAA tournament the last couple of years. Lost to Gonzaga 2 years ago, beat BYU, and lost to Ohio State last year. Georgia's guys, none of them have ever been in it. They are playing with great passion at this end.
First time since 2002 for the Bulldogs in the tournament. Lost to Southern Illinois, Bob, in that game in the second round, mind you, by 2.
Well, the defense of the interior players for Dennis Felton has been excellent in this game. That's why Xavier only shot 34% in the first half. Very few offensive rebounds given up. But right now, Xavier's starting to execute a little bit better.
Jeremy Price fouled with his first. That sends Anderson to the line. Hits the first of 2. And Monday, the madness continues with a hit new comedy, The Big Bang Theory. That's Monday at 8. 7 Central, only on CBS. Anderson struggled in the first half, 0 for 2 from the floor.
Well, we haven't seen full court pressure on the part of Xavier yet in this game, and I suspect we're going to get that sometime. Watch this matchup going down the stretch right here. Burrell, the player of the year defensively in the Atlantic 10, against Gaines, the do-all guard for the Dogs.
Xavier trying to get themselves back in for the free throw line, but how about that shot? Oh, falling away, Billy Humphrey. 9 for Humphrey. That's a big one to start here about, what, 5 minutes into the second half. A three-point shot goes down just when Xavier was trying to make a run back.
It was an answer, wasn't it? One of those momentum killers.
46-36. That ball is loose. And Georgia comes out of the pack again. Corey Butler. Get a little sloppy. Woodbury.
Had a notion, huh?
Oh, I thought he's going to pull the trigger, and he saw his buddy Gaines and thought again.
Wise play.
Humphrey stop and go. Hangs on a pivot looking for help. That ball is stolen. No. Taken back.
Clock keeps going, though, right here.
10 on the shot for Gaines.
I don't think he knows it.
Down to 5. Down to 4. Slides in. Left hand high off the glass. And the loose ball is down on the floor. Shot clock went dry. Never touched the rim. And Xavier tries to run down court. It's knocked away. And 32 on the shot clock.
High intensity level in this game on both teams' parts. What you would expect in the NCAA tournament. Frequent substitutions now by both coaches. Trying to keep their players fresh for the run down the end. The last 14 seed to beat a 3, Northwestern State. That's not Northwestern. Northwestern State beat Iowa in Detroit in 2006. It is a rare occurrence indeed.
Burrell around the screen by Duncan. Josh Duncan with a 10-point night. And drives baseline and a foul.
Nearly a technical right there. Jackson upset with himself. Bounced the ball very high and at Hightower, calming him down, and his teammates helping him out as well.
And Bob, just directly across from us, Xavier fans, and they were up and they were giving that T sign, trying to help out Ed Hightower and his crew.
Ed doesn't need any help. Remember, we saw him in the airport in South Bend one day, and we talked to him after the game. Announcers and officials travel the same roads together. Albert Jackson, what a good job he's done so far, huh? 3 fouls, but aggressive play. And they are rotating. He, Price, and Bliss inside. Felton's got 3 guys and 15 fouls.
Duncan now beginning to warm up from the free throw line. 46-38 Georgia. And across the timeline goes Gaines, a senior from Jamaica, New York. That ball is loose. Everybody piles on. And Bob, every time you see that, what comes to mind is that rugby scrum.
It sure does. Right here, watch how he splits this. When Duncan comes out, he goes through, unfortunately loses the handle, and then everybody's after it. The play where you go through the double team like that is a risky one, and that illustrates why.
Possession, Georgia. Gaines lobs it out front. And Bliss on the floor with 3 fouls.
What a leader this guy is.
Oh, that's a tough shot. Turning, aired it up. And Xavier out of the pack. Here comes Dante Jackson. Out front, Duncan drives in. Took on a triple team, follows up the shot. How about that? He's still on the floor. Loose. Raymond shoots it up and good.
Right place at the right time for BJ Raymond.
Hit a 3 in the first half, and now Xavier fans trying to will the Musketeers back against Georgia.
You don't think they're going to give up? They've won 13 out of their last 15. Underneath. Aggression. Duncan takes his man off the dribble and gets knocked around. Bodies everywhere. Number 11, Raymond, waiting for it to pop out. An easy one. You know, Xavier's a team, Craig, that's not going to go away. As I mentioned, 13 out of their last 15, they have won. And they have played very good competition in the Atlantic 10 and also played Tennessee, Arizona State, Indiana, Kansas State. So Sean Miller and his guys know how to win.
Well, you just saw the 2008 Atlantic 10 Coach of the Year. And for a reason, a 27-6 record and 14-2 in conference play. Bliss out front. An offensive foul, and the finger is pointed at Billy Humphrey.
Humphrey used his offhand to push off to try to create some space. On the playground, you can do that, but this is the NCAA tournament. It's not allowed. Used his hand to push off Burrell. Burrell, a great defender.
Georgia with their eighth turnover. Xavier down six with the basketball.
Look at this denial. Boy, they are all the way out on the floor. You would think Lavender might be able to penetrate.
And a whistle away from the ball.
Well, Ed Hightower is going to talk to both Burrell and Humphrey right here. They're guarding one another. They're pounding each other. Humphrey especially has to keep his cool.
And two now on Billy Humphrey.
In the last 10 seconds. Burrell's an interesting story. As Hightower talks to Humphrey, cools him down. That's a good bit of officiating. Burrell is a guy who's a 1,000-point scorer for Xavier, Craig, and yet he's been taking fewer and fewer shots as his career has gone on, and he has become a great defensive player. We mentioned he was voted the defensive player of the year in the Atlantic 10. He has sacrificed. He's only 0-for-3 today.
Finally, on the board, his first free throw. You know, as you mentioned, the Atlantic 10 Defensive Player of the Year. He's in great company. Two other Xavier players join Burrell with that honor. 99, James Posey. 2002, David West. Those two make the play.
Yeah, and David West was the Player of the Year nationally that year.
46-42, Xavier making a run at the Georgia Bulldogs. Swansea. Rolls it out front, leaves it out to Bliss. Boy, defensive pressure really picking up here by Xavier. And everybody on the deck, they're dusting the floor. Timeout, Xavier.
You see a troubled steel business. At Franklin Templeton, we saw a chance to invest in a re-engineered steel company poised for a turnaround, building strong returns for our fund shareholders. Perspective like this has made Mutual Series a leader in value investing. Franklin Templeton Investments. Gain from our perspective. Ask your advisor for a prospectus with investment goals, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing.
Well, Bob, it was a 9-point Georgia lead at the break. Xavier has rallied to cut it to 4, and you look at the 3-14 matchups this season. Well, Xavier, Georgia, Louisville, Boise State, Wisconsin, and Fullerton, Stanford, the Cardinal taking on Cornell.
Well, the big thing that we're trying to point out here is, in terms of name recognition, the guys on the right are all from lesser conferences except for Georgia. And that is the unusual thing in this tournament, to have a team from the Southeastern Conference as a 14 seed is highly unusual. As a matter of fact, never happened. Xavier has really made a good comeback right here. Their aggression on defense is very admirable. High marks in that area.
And free throws. They've been able to hit free throws as Ed Hightower goes to the scorers table. They had 15 on the shot, and they're going to reset that, of course, to 35.
Mr. Hightower, one of the best officials in all of college basketball.
And an official timeout, 46-42 Georgia on CBS.
Thank you very much for coming.
Well, Bob, every year some great stories in the tournament. And as you look, five teams from the state of Tennessee playing in the tournament, eight Big East teams in the NCAAs, also both teams from the 07 finals. That means Ohio State and Florida not in the tournament this year. And how about Beasley, Mayo, Love? All will make their tourney debuts
tonight.
A lot of stuff going on right there. And as far as our game, we are seeing aggression. Guys diving on the floor, falling out of bounds. Everybody going after the ball at the same time. Guys tackling each other, kicking one another in the face unintentionally. This is the kind of game that we've been seeing here. And this is very, very fun to watch.
Georgia's largest lead, 11, and has been trimmed down to 4. Free throws, a big difference. 10 of 14 for Xavier. Georgia, 2 for 2 thus far.
Yeah, that's unbelievable. One time I was coaching, and Jim Burr, the great official, I was in a detriment like that. And I said, they took 14, we only took 2. And he says, tell your guys to stop fouling.
Lavender, deep. Ricochets off the rim. Big rebound by the big fella, Dave Bliss. And who does he find quickly? Gaines. On the wing is Butler. On that low block, Price hangs. That ball taken away. Another giveaway by Georgia, and they take it right back.
What hands by Gaines. Alert.
Drops it off to Butler. Good look. Squares up. Hard off the rim. Guess who? Gaines follows. And a foul. Off the rebound.
That there is a reason that that guy in your picture leads this team in every statistical category. He hustles, he gets the steal, and then on this miss, he gets the offensive rebound. Leading scorer, leading rebounder, leading assist guy, leading steals guy on this team.
And Bob, we're not talking 3 or 4 rebounds. Gaines, 6.1 rebounds a ball game. Only one of 8 players in the country to lead his team in those 4 categories.
6 rebounds is a lot for a guard.
Under 11 minutes to play. 46-42 Georgia. Gaines out front.
Nobody uses the dribble on Georgia unless they need to. They catch, they use the dribble when they're going somewhere.
Jeremy Price hands it to Humphrey. Shot clock down to 12. Good look. Wide open 3. That ball just flew off the side of the iron by Woodbury. And in the corner, another battle. And we're going the other way. And boy, is Dave Bliss emotional about that call.
Mr. Bliss better be careful right here. Hustle on both guys' part. He felt that they were both out of bounds when that ball was hit off his leg.
And Dennis Felton is going to set Bliss for a while.
You don't think that guy wants to win, huh?
Oh.
Been here for 4 years. Has not had a stellar career, and this is his opportunity.
Lavender out front. Always draws that double team. They drop it down on the corner. Duncan deep. One bouncing off. And the rebound to Georgia. Albert Jackson's been around that hoop all day.
And he got help inside right there. Humphrey blocked out.
Oh, how quick. No question when he took that shot. It's going for 3.
This is the 1-3-1 zone that was so effective in the first half. Look in the back. Gaines, number 2, will run from corner to corner. Jackson has to guard the middle.
Anderson clears it away. Burrell on the wing with the left hand. Drops it inside. Anderson and a reach-in foul.
Gaines is going to get that one.
That will be 3 on Sunday out of Gaines.
Well, right here, this is a cause for concern for Dennis Felton. The lead player on his team with 3 fouls right now. He's got to be very, very careful down the stretch here. 9 minutes to go is an eternity.
C.J. Anderson. A couple of free throws here in the second half. Back at the line. And Bob, Xavier was making their way back from the free throw line, and here they are again. Well, feel the heat when Monday's number one drama returns with an all-new episode, CSI Miami. That's at 10, 9 Central on CBS.
I love Horatio when he always gets the bad guys.
Always.
Thank you.
Anderson drops down two, and CJ will go to the bench. Anderson helping the Xavier cause here with a 4-for-4 free throw effort in the second half.
Well, we knew this game wasn't going to get expanded. We knew it was going to get closer. And right now, Duncan and Woodbury, the leading scorers for their teams. But this guy with the basketball, Gaines, is going to control the game for the Dogs down the stretch. Humphrey and Woodbury need to tune it up from deep.
Good look. Humphrey just hit a three a minute ago. That one came off the rim. Burrell in transition off the rim. Here comes Georgia. Are you surprised Xavier isn't showing a little bit more patience with that shot?
Well, with 9 minutes to go in the game, it's still pretty good. I mean, you got to take the first good one you can get against Georgia's defense.
Burrell gives it off. Another in, and the two-hander. Derrick Brown, 13 points to lead the Musketeers.
There's a reason they're the three seed, and you're seeing it. They were down deep, and they've dug in defensively.
And the Bulldog lead of 11, now three. Humphrey cuts in, now drops back off Jackson.
Watch the pressure on the basketball, the long arms.
Gaines on the lob, and there's a foul on the reach-in. Jason Love.
Well, foul, defensive Jeremy intensity Price. Leads to steals, and this is what happens when you can get that defense going. The finishes are easy. Brown with the dunk. Burrell with the pass, and that's what you want out of your defense, to create offense. Sean Miller, a great point guard in his own right.
Gaines on the bounce to Humphrey. Dribbles out of traffic, hands it to Woodbury. That ball is slapped away. Great anticipation by Anderson.
Second steal in a row of the same variety.
Boy, Xavier fans on their feet. I have a feeling they're not going to sit the rest of the way.
2-3 zone on the part of Dennis Felton right here, trying to change things up. His problem has not been this end. It's been the other end. Offensively, they've become stagnant.
Clock is under 8 minutes to play. Raymond. Yes! B.J. Raymond. Second free ball of the afternoon, and what do you know? Xavier making a run, 49-all.
George has been very tentative. They got to take it hard with the dribble.
Gaines took it hard. The follow falls off the rim. Loose ball, Musketeers, 2-on-2. Burrell. Yes! Jackson! By the freshman, put Xavier on top. Jackson, the freshman, Bob, just hit the three to put the Musketeers on top. By the way, April 7th, Jackson turns 20. That just happens to be championship night in San Antonio.
Oh, you're starting to think about those things already, huh? Terrific shot by Jackson. He's telling Lavender that Coach Miller wants to talk to him a little bit. They want to bring up the pressure full court. This is what I think they should have been doing a little bit earlier. Trying to wear out Gaines and make him more fatigued as we get to the late stages of the game.
Jackson picks up the senior. Hands that ball off. Humphrey. Gaines on the wing as we reach the 7 minute mark.
They're setting staggered screens for Gaines, trying to get him an opportunity.
Anderson picks up the foul, his second. Timeout. We'll be back. Buckle up on CBS.
Greg Gumbel in New York with an update. Fear not for the top seed, Kansas Jayhawks. They continue to roll, coming up on 4.5 minutes to play. They lead Portland State 73-46. They're headed for a date with the winner of UNLV and Kent State. Let's send you back to Washington, Craig and Bob.
Bob, a lot of numbers jump out at you, but you look at the turnovers. Georgia with 11. Xavier scored 11 off those 11 turnovers, and the Musketeers have been at the free throw line 12 times, or 16 times, making 12. 2 for 2, the Bulldogs.
Yeah, that's not many, is it? And I'll tell you what, they're not getting fouled because they're not taking the ball to the basket strongly. They're doing a great job of taking away the penetration of Gaines. Jackson really working hard on him.
Gaines held to just one bucket here in the second half. Dropped down 7 in the first 20 minutes. Inside, the big fella. Shut down. Clears it. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Humphrey's in a crowd. Boy, Xavier's really picked it up defensively. Hump Woodbury puts it up. One bounce and out. It's out of bounds.
Xavier has been on the run, and this has been fueled by their defense. Raymond from deep, he made a three, and then on the next possession, a steal. Burrell finds Jackson, and that's the play that gave him the lead. Xavier's shown why they're a number three seed, and Mr. Burrell may not have a stat line, but his defense has been the biggest contributing factor to the turnaround right now.
Well, he's rugged. 55th straight start today here in the opening round of the Western Region. Xavier with the lead in the basketball. Lavender back over his shoulder to Duncan. Tough shot. Rolls in two more.
Duncan's been so valuable at the offensive end, like Burrell has been at the defensive end. He has a huge guard skill set, but he's 6'9", and the post players from Georgia are having trouble guarding him away from the basket.
And Bob Duncan had a great streak during February. During a three-game stretch, he hit 16 straight field goals.
He's got the offensive game, and right now, Jackson is out. Burrell, well-rested, guarding Gaines.
Woodbury out front to Gaines, 10 on the shot clock.
They've got to find answers other than Gaines.
Xavier really pushing them out beyond the perimeter. Gaines again driving, lost it, but guess who? Price helps him out. First bucket for the 6'8 freshman. Here in the second half on the other end. Duncan tried to put an exclamation mark. And a foul on Bliss, his fourth.
Well, last possession, Duncan goes one-on-one. This possession, he outruns the big guys. Bliss feels like he pinned it against the backboard for a block. Duncan's going to get his opportunities at the free throw line.
Duncan, 5 of 8 from the charity stripe.
Yeah, he's a senior, usually the sixth man, but he started in this game. Averages nearly 12 a game. Bliss with his fourth. He's going to get a little rest, and Jackson's going to replace him. The same three-man rotation with Bliss, Jackson, and Price for Georgia.
One more for Duncan.
He's been very good in this game, as you can see from his numbers. A very difficult guy to guard for a big man.
Xavier, they've made their last 12 free throws.
You know how teams lament when they lose in the tournament because they didn't shoot free throws well? Well, this is just the opposite, huh? Keep in mind now, Georgia has been in tight games. They won 2 in overtime in the SEC tournament not too long ago.
Against Ole Miss and Kentucky. And then went on to beat Mississippi State and Arkansas. In the title game, Georgia has to keep a hold of that basketball. Possession belongs to the Bulldogs. 19 on the shot clock.
It's also worth noting that Xavier, 13 out of 15 games have been wins. The two losses were both to St. Joseph's, and they were low-scoring games like this one.
Xavier averages, Bob, great points, 75 points a ball game. Bulldog 68, there's another steal. Brown on the other end. Got it!
Credit Burrell with this steal. Back to Burrell, back to Brown. No dribbles, 93 feet, and an and-one coming up. Boy, their defense has been spectacular in the last 5 minutes. Brown jumped out in the passing lane there. Burrell was pressuring Gaines. It wasn't even his man who he jumped out in the passing lane on. This guy was setting the screen.
Billy Humphrey whistle for his third foul, and quickly Bliss will check back in. And Jackson goes out for Georgia. And Bob, again, the story here, free throws. The opportunity to be at the line for Xavier. 16 for Derrick Brown.
Teams that are used to winning, like Xavier, make big plays, especially when they're experienced and well-schooled. They've won 27 games this year, and it is showing in the late stages.
Bob, big possession here to quiet the Xavier crowd. Everyone on their feet. Xavier all the way back from 11 down. Gaines kind of did all by himself. What a great play by Gaines. That's 11, the senior from Jamaica, New York. But can he do it by himself?
Well, I'll tell you what, that time he did, but he has not been in the last few minutes. Some guys in the red jerseys are a little reticent right now. Woodbury and Humphrey are the other likely candidates. They're not going to be able to pass the ball inside and score that way.
Xavier just happy to run some clock down to 10. Lavender nearly lost the dribble. 7, down to 6, down to 5, down to 4. Lavender floater, yes! Big!
The little guy going big, huh? Those floaters are difficult.
61-53, Xavier. Gaines, left to right hand, clears it out front. Georgia desperate for a bucket. Humphrey shut down. Pull up, 3, got it! How big, Bob, how big was that shot?
Woodbury did an unbelievable job there. The step back 3.
Raymond finds Duncan straight away. In the corner. That ball is kicked out. Georgia has it. Here comes LeBury. And I'm watching Gaines. He is the last man across midcourt. Tired is that young man. Gaines. Just behind the three-point arc. 3:20 on the clock. Shot clock to 17.
You're right. He's trying to get a rest here on this possession.
Pull up. Free throw line and a foul.
Well, we said Woodbury or Humphrey have to step up, and Woodbury has taken it to himself.
Taste Papa John's perfect pan pizza and experience pan.
Greg Gumbel in New York with an update. Michigan State continues to roll out in Denver. Chris Allen's 3 has the Spartans on top as they come up on 5 minutes to play. They look headed for a date with the winner of Pitt against Oral Roberts. Let's get you back to Washington.
Xavier 61, Georgia 56, West Region in Washington, D.C. Well, the timeouts, Georgia with 3, Xavier with 1. Possession arrow, pointing to the Musketeers. And Bob, let's talk about for a moment Georgia. Now, we talk about fatigue. I'm not talking physical. How about mental fatigue with this Bulldog team after what happened in Atlanta?
Well, the tornado, the 4 games in 4 days, 3.5 days, actually, it's got to take an emotional toll. But I'll tell you what, coming in here, they did not want to use that as an excuse in any way, shape, or form. And I think that's the right approach. When asked about fatigue, Dennis Felton said, what fatigue?
We haven't talked about it.
That's right.
We have, because you have to wonder.
Well, that's a tough miss right there for Woodbury. He made a good play right there and got to the line, but dramatic difference in the first and second halves in this game. And credit Xavier's defense. High marks in man-to-man, and that has shut down the Dogs when they needed it most.
Down the stretch in Washington, D.C., first game of the West Region. And it's been wild from the start. Xavier working themselves back from a 9-point deficit at the break. And they have a 61-57 lead, just under 3 minutes to play.
And they've done it with spectacular defense, turning the Dogs down at every opportunity. And they have made some timely threes as well, B.J. Raymond and Jackson, to give them the lead. Xavier has won 27 games. They know how to win, and the free throw discrepancy has been gigantic in this game.
20th attempt, and Anderson drops it. CJ with 5 points, all from the free throw line. Georgia, of course, trying to shake off fatigue from the SEC championship run in Atlanta. Four wins in 4 days, overtime victories against Ole Miss, Kentucky, then Mississippi State, and in the title game beat the Razorbacks of Arkansas.
Ironically enough, because of the tornadoes, those games played at Georgia Tech, which, if you didn't know, is a rival of Georgia.
And a much smaller arena. They had to pack him in tight. And the man that led him, Sundiata Gaines, with the dribble, runs it across midcourt, 25 on the shot clock, 2:45 to play. Gaines inside, wrapped up, and they're going to call jump.
That's going to be Xavier's ball.
Possession arrow, Musketeers.
You talk about terrific defense. Xavier has it. It's like there's seven guys out there. Burrell really doing a great job individually on Gaines. And you can see why he's the player of the year defensively in the Atlantic 10. Three Atlantic 10 teams in the tournament. St. Joseph's and Temple also. Six from the SEC. Tennessee, Vandy, Kentucky, Mississippi State, Arkansas, and these dogs.
And Bob, for those who just joined us, 11-point lead in the first half by Georgia. It was trimmed to 9, and little by little, Xavier never panicked. Fans got behind them as well, and you really see the reason why they've won 27 games on the season. Inside the dish, good defense, and it's blocked. Bulldog basketball, still breathing with 2:27 to play.
That was a nice play, and unfortunately, they didn't get something out of it. Nice back door, roll reversal with Duncan making the pass. Love comes in because he has extracurricular defense on his mind. And the defense of Xavier has been spectacular to watch. The hustle everywhere, taking Gaines out of the game. Burrell has been there, and Brown has been there. It's led to a lot of easy baskets at the other end.
Eight steals along the way for Xavier. Humphrey controlled the dribble out front. Boy, I tell you, Xavier in the second half, Bob, pushing behind the three-point line. Tough shot. Three hops and down for Gaines. That's two the hard way.
Oh, I'm telling you, that was difficult. Felton trying to direct his guy, encouraging from the sideline.
And now Georgia, their fans behind us on their feet, trying to push them over the top. 1:50 to play. Four-point ball game.
Got to get a stop here if it's going to be difficult. Gonna be foul on Georgia. The hard drive by Burrell. Three guys come into it. Wow.
Corey Butler. And I think he got his money's worth. That looked like a tailback or a fullback going off the four hole.
Well, it's what you expect in the NCAA tournament. Aggression. Both of these teams know how to be physical.
I'll make sure you stay tuned. Kentucky will take on Marquette later. Baylor, Purdue, Oral Roberts, and Pitt. And then Kent State taking on the running Rebels of UNLV.
Watch out for Pittsburgh, the Big East champions in the tournament. And they are back to full strength, and Jamie Dixon's team is very, very dangerous.
First miss by Burrell, and a rare miss by Xavier in this ball game. So Duncan goes out for Xavier. Brown is back in. Burrell's two-point day, 5 assists, and 4 of the 8 steals. It makes a second of two.
And his defense has become contagious.
64-59, dump down, Bliss for two. Three buckets for the big fella.
What a pass by Gaines.
Wow.
No quitting these dogs, baby.
Absolutely, they're barking. Timeout, Xavier.
And a good one. The seniors take over. Gaines and Bliss, they want to keep playing.
They can be aviation electricians, healthcare technicians, computer technicians.
For the best coverage, switch to AT&T. More bars in more places.
Kelly! Kelly Moore!
And now get an exclusive smartphone for
$99.99. Gotcha.
1:24 to play. 64-61 Xavier. We reset it for you. And Bob, maybe the biggest point, no timeouts. remaining for the Musketeers. And I'll tell you, 124 in the college game can be a long time.
Yeah, but unfortunately for them, they have the lead, so they don't need to be calling timeouts. Georgia has some timeouts, and when you're behind, you need those. Aggression, but without fouling for the part of Dennis Felton's team. That would be the formula for them to get one more possession.
Right now, the most important issue for the Bulldogs, a defensive stop. As Lavender picks it up against Gaines and a touch foul.
Oh my.
Gaines is fourth.
They are 18 for 23 from the free throw line. Georgia only 3 for 4 from the charity stripe.
So Drew Lavender, 85% on the season from the free throw line. Will attempt his first of the day and drops it with ease.
Drew played for Oklahoma for 2 years and played in the NCAA tournament for them. 4 fouls on Gaines, and now he has played for Xavier in the NCAA tournament as well. His third time.
13 for Drew Lavender. 5-point ball game, 1:17 on the clock. Is it time for a three? You work it inside.
Either way, whatever's comfortable. They're spreading right here, looking for a three.
Oh, in and out. And a foul. Bob, from our angle, that ball was down, took a spin, and worked itself out.
Woodbury almost made that one. They were really, really spread out on this. And right here, Butler comes in from the right side of your screen. He is not blocked out. And he is knocked to the ground and has an opportunity to get them a score with the clock stopped.
C.J. Anderson whistle for his third foul. Bliss will go out. And Albert Jackson checks in. That's been Dennis Felton's rhythm, his system throughout this game. And now Corey Butler, a walk-on, Bob, from Decatur, Georgia, a junior at the line. That ball kicked hard, save, Duncan baseline. How about that?
Wow! You talk about saving the game for Xavier, the long arms of Duncan.
Under a minute to go, Bliss. And a foul, Woodbury.
How about Duncan walking the tightrope here? Saves it. In the past, people would call a timeout. Can't do that anymore. Duncan's really played a terrific game, hasn't he?
Oh, terrific.
He's been a tough matchup for the big guys for Georgia. He's got guard skill set, and yet he's 6'9".
16 points, Bob, 7 rebounds, and 7 of 10 from the free throw line. 8 of 11.
Well, Xavier knows what it is to be a 14 seed. A couple of years ago, they were the 14 seed and lost a tough one to Gonzaga. Georgia now understands what it is to be a 14 seed, and Xavier knows what it is to be a 3 seed.
And the free throws continue to fall. Raymond goes out for Xavier after the 2 free throws by Duncan. And now Georgia will call a timeout with 51 ticks left on the clock, trailing by 7.
Cash toward accessories.
Seven-point ball game. Xavier rallying back from 9 down at the half. And Bob, if you look at three-point shooting for Georgia, Billy Humphrey, 37%. Corey Butler, nearly 40. 39% shooter. And if you want to know about Mr. Gaines, a 30% three-point shooter. And they need a three.
Well, they do need a three. And then Woodbury is the guy who made the last one from them from deep. They are spread out right now. Xavier's defense has been the story of this game in the second half.
Gaines wastes no time, gets it across the timeline. And on that perimeter, Butler calls for it straight away. Gaines deep for 3. No, rebound, Xavier. And that's going to do it. As Dave Bliss reaches in, and that's 5. Bliss battling all day long as we look at today's Chevrolet Players of the Game. And Sundiata Gaines played his heart out, 13.6 assists. And how about Josh Duncan? Give this guy credit on both the offense and defensive ends.
Both are seniors. Both, of course, Josh will continue his career right now. The last college game for Gaines, if things go like we think they will in the last 30 seconds. Very big hill to climb for Dennis Felton and his team. But I'll tell you what, a team that has shown heart throughout. Dave Bliss, career as a collegian, probably over. And he was an inspiration to his pals. And you can see their appreciation for his effort.
And Bob, free throws the key. By the way, Xavier ranked 18th overall in Division I as a team from the free throw line, 75%.
And that helped tonight, indeed. I was so impressed with Xavier's defense. Their man-to-man, their principles, their hustle, their diving for the loose balls, staying in front of their man so they don't have to help. And Georgia can be proud that they even made it to the field this year. What a remarkable run for the Dogs in the SEC tournament.
Musketeers 23 of 28. Now 24 of 29. Never lost their cool. You could always see they were in control despite the 11-point disadvantage, down 9 at the half. They continue to play hard, rebound, and really, really play some tough defense.
I think experience showed in this game. Seniors who have been in the tournament, Lavender, Burrell, and Duncan all played terrific games in this one. Their leadership, very, very important. And the athleticism of Brown as well.
Xavier fans begin to celebrate. Bob, I think Georgia can go back with Dennis Felton and understand and work and build on the success in the final week and a half of this season.
Indeed they can. And of course, Xavier will get a rest tomorrow. And they will be very anxious to see who they will play. The winner of the Purdue-Baylor game will be their opponent.
Well, the final score will not indicate just how tough a battle this game was for Xavier. One more for Duncan. 20-point night. And Duncan gets a nice hand as he goes out.
A nightmare matchup for big guys is Duncan. At 6'9 and 235, he can put it on the floor and shoot outside. Very difficult to guard.
Brown will dribble out the clock. No, he did not. And a foul, and we're going to shoot two more. So the first advancement is Xavier here in the West region.
The 3 seed beats the 14, and Georgia gave them one heck of a game. And Xavier, I think you can see how well balanced this team is, how they have superior intellect and terrific defensive intensity, and that's why they are a 3 seed in the national tournament. Sean Miller building great things at Xavier.
Gaines takes a walk, a long walk to that Georgia bench, and he was met by his nemesis today, Stanley Burrell. That was classy. Came over, just gave him a high five. And there's a rare miss. Georgia will take the final shot. And it's over. ...73-61. Xavier moves on to round two. We go to New York to Greg Gumbel.
All right, Craig, so the Musketeers avoid the upset. They come back to beat the Georgia Bulldogs by a score of 73-61. Our next wave of games coming your way. Kent State UNLV tips at 2:53 Eastern time. In Denver, Oral Roberts will take on Pitt. 3:05 is the tip time for that game. And in Washington, Baylor and Purdue will tip about a half.